This whole show, we've been looking at that 3D printer working its way through building something. But what you may not have known is that the thing is alive, or at least made of tissue. 3D bioprinting is a new method that blends traditional 3D printing techniques with biomedical engineering. And here to break down this process is graduate student Blass Watson. What is going on?
So, first off, Bill, a little bit of a reminder about what 3D printing is. So 3D printing is an additive manufacturing process where layers upon layers of material are put down. And so you take a 3D model and you put down a single flat layer down
this
like
is,
this.
What is this, a rooftop?
So this should be a monument that is a little bit familiar to most people in Memphis. And then as these layers start
the
getting put down, eventually you end up with a finished little model here, and here we have the pyramid.
Look,
right here.
And it has the Bass Pro sign on it.
I don't know if you can see, it's a little bright under the studio
lights.
That is
so cool. And so this is the bottom part, and then it just keeps layering.
And it just keeps putting thin layers on top of each other.
Oh my God, how long did that take to make?
This one right here took 4 hours to print.
So. Wow, and so tell me what we're printing right now, what we've been seeing. It said it's a heart.
Right. It is a heart. Now, granted, it's not a full-scale heart. It'd be a little bit too long to do that, but it is.
And what are we seeing? Like, yeah.
All right.
What's
so
it doing?
The kind of opaque material right there, that is a gel. It's a gelatin material. It's a bunch of tiny little microspheres of gelatin. Imagine kind of like packing peanuts, but kind of compressed down to like minuscule scale. Mm-hmm. Now, the reason we use that is because obviously a heart's not a very kind of self-supporting model. It needs something as we're building it to kind of support it as it's being made.
Right.
And so these little spheres kind of like imagine as these packing peanut kind of go along, they support the heart. And as you put all the layers down and whenever it's done, you take that material and since it's just gelatin, you can heat it up and it melts out and you're left with the finished piece.
Wow, and so that is the size of a mouse, right? That's a heart.
That would be about equivalent to a mouse or rat heart.
Okay.
So it's not exactly. Now, please, disclaimer, because we're in a studio, these have no live cells, and as cool as it would be, we're still a good bit of years away from actually having, you know, an implantable heart for someone.
And let's talk about that. And you have another printout here, but tell me what that is and then the ultimate goal for 3D bioprinting.
Right, right. So one of the nice things about 3D printing and one of the reasons we use it is because 3D printing itself is a technique that, by its definition, gives you a unique piece whenever you're finished. And so this right here, some of you might recognize it, this is a hip. And this is specifically, this is a hip recreated.
And the little.
With a ball and socket. This is a hip recreated from an x-ray, from a couple of x-rays that were scanned, and then we used software to kind of make it into a certain shape, into a 3D printable model. Sliced it, prepared it, all that fun stuff. And then this is an exact match to scale of that person's hip. So the nice thing about this bioprinting is because everyone's unique, everyone's injury or organ's going to be a little bit different. And so we can match that to what the exact person for the particular injury. So my work at the University of Memphis, I'm part of the UTHSC Memphis Joint Bioengineering Program, is working on skeletal muscle tissue. I'm working to, your biceps, forceps, pecs, all that fun.
Fun stuff?
Fun stuff.
Is it fun? Okay.
For me, it is.
I just meant like just imagining the injury. No, but it is, this is really, I love this. How far out, as you can, if you could show us what the final product would be, while you're taking that out, if you could just tell us how far along we are from actually implanting these in people's bodies.
That's more of a question for the FDA more than me. But that is one of the things about this is it is quite a number of years away. I would say at minimum 20 years.
Okay. But you have to do this work. This is the
exactly.
foundation.
Exactly. This is the foundation.
This is what we'll see at the end of that.
Yes, this is a kind of pre-prepared, and now you take it out of the oven and you have a finished product. This is so what we would do, like I said earlier, as you get this kind of ready, it's kind of gloopy. There it is.
That's an actual shape of an actual heart.
That is the actual shape of a heart.
Was it a rat or a human?
This is a scan of a human heart.
Oh my God, whose?
I cannot reveal that.
This is a secret heart.
Okay. It's modeled off freely available kind of models online, anatomical models online.
Gotcha.
And when the models were published, they did not say whose heart that was.
Well, I hope you guys can see that. Can you tell us about, we have like literally minus 5 seconds, E-Day, and who can come?
Engineering Day at the University of Memphis. It is open to most people at the Herf Engineering College. If you are an engineering student, feel free to come down, and if you're interested in biomedical, mechanical, all sorts of fun engineering stuff, we'll be happy to have you there and show you some of the cool things we have. We have stuff from ultrasound, 3D printing, cool medical implants of that sort and other. Happy to show you.
I really appreciate this work because, you know, when I'm like 100, I'm going to need it. So thank you.
Yeah. Well,
thank you.
You're welcome.
All right.
Okay.
All right, a 3D heart printed right here.
You're welcome.